This is a highly venomous black long spine urchin, and I found it under just one of the 100 rocks I'll be flipping in this video.
Oh, what is this thing?
My mission is to head along the coast to a section of reef called the graveyard, flipping all the rocks, pots, and other debris I find along the way. But the graveyard is called that for good reason. For at night, it's covered in creatures with sharp teeth and the deadliest neurotoxic venom in the ocean. And at the end of this video, you'll understand why flipping rocks is a bad idea.
Oh, that's definitely a rock I don't want to flip. I'm getting out of here.
Now, flipping rocks has the potential to disturb marine life, so it's important to set some ground rules. The first rule is that if I can see what's under a rock or pot without flipping it, like pot number 3, it'll remain unflipped.
Oh, I can see some eyes staring back at me.
It's quite unusual to see this pair of white-eyed morays hunkered down in the same crevice. And this is why it's a good idea not to go putting your hands in dark places. But you've also got to be careful where you put your face too.
Oh, I've got to be careful, there's a scorpionfish just here, I nearly landed on it.
This scorpionfish is venomous, but nothing like as venomous as the creatures that patrol the graveyard. The second rule is that all rocks and pots will be placed back down exactly where they are found.
Right back where we found it. Perfect.
And the final rule is that I'll only flip rocks and pots that are loose, like pot number 6.
This is a big one. Let's see what's hiding under here. Oh, we've got a weird... What is that? Oh, it's a pistol shrimp. That's crazy. Oh, where's he gone? He's probably looking for a burrow.
These pistol shrimps are known for their oversized claw, that they can snap shut so fast it creates a cavitation bubble that produces a shockwave strong enough to stun or kill small prey. They also use it to keep probing fingers out of their hiding holes.
Ow!
That click you can hear is the sound of the pistol shrimp firing his gun, and it's so loud it can interfere with sonar equipment. But other weaponized critters also patrol these reefs, like the one we found under rock number 21.
Now let's see what's under this rock. Oh, we've got a little mantis shrimp. And that, I believe, is a checkered eye mantis.
Now, like other species of punching mantis shrimp, these checkered eye mantis shrimps are armed with club-like appendages that they use to beat their prey to death. They can often be seen rootling around in the rocks and muck, looking for food, and they pick them out with their highly evolved visual organs. They also come in a wide variety of colours.
Oh, a little green mantis shrimp! And this one blends in perfectly with the algae!
Now, I believe these two mantis shrimps are the same species, but it's interesting to see how much colour variation occurs, even over very short distances. But whilst many creatures use colour to remain undetected, other critters have developed much more advanced methods of camouflage. And a critter hiding under rock number 27 has perhaps the most highly evolved camo in the ocean.
This little orange thing looks like a leaf floating around in the current, but it's actually a juvenile batfish. To predators, these guys don't look like prey, they just look like a leaf. And when they get a bit older, they'll start swimming normally. Although, the adults are a bit weird too.
The ocean floor here is covered in flippable debris. From pots and pans to bags and ropes, and almost everything we flipped was home to a number of different marine creatures.
Let's flip this little rock just here. Oh, blimey! It's a hermit crab! It suddenly developed legs and now it's walking around! That is crazy! Look at it go!
But you will not believe what we found under rock number 29.
Got ya.
So, the next bit of flippable debris we found was an old metal pipe, but wedged inside was perhaps the most charismatic fish in the ocean.
So, I was about to flip this thing, but there's a massive burrfish in it! Oh, there he goes! That has got to be one of the coolest fish on the reef!
Unfortunately, this little orbicular burrfish appears to be blind in one eye, perhaps caused by an injury or an infection. It's a good job, though, that he's a pufferfish and can inflate his needle-covered body when threatened, especially given the fact that he doesn't seem to know where he's going.
Oh, he's doing a U-turn and coming back, I think. Hello, buddy. Nice to see you again.
But there was something else hiding on the metal pipe.
Whoa, what is that?
This is a high-fin fang blenny. Now, these blennies are actually parasitic and use long fangs to bite down on the lips and skin of larger fish, feeding on their mucus and tissue. This is called kleptoparasitism, and it's possible that the big burrfish was on this little fang blenny's menu. However, other species that hide under rocks have traded fang-like teeth for other needle-sharp weaponry.
Okay, so this rock here is covered in damsels. Let's have a look what's hiding under here. Oh, what is that? It looks like a little lionfish. Oh, it is! It's a little juvenile lionfish just here. There's my finger look for a size reference. Oh, I think he just ate something.
The reef in this area is a nursery for many juvenile lionfish species that hide amongst the rubble and algae. But when fully grown, these lionfish will head to the graveyard, and they are fearless and voracious predators.
Right, let's put this pot back down so he can go and tuck himself back under. There he goes, look, under he goes. Right, let's go find another rock to flip.
So many small reef fish like gobies, blennies, damsels, and juvenile groupers take cover under rocks and other debris on the ocean floor. But the best real estate isn't always available, so some are forced to take shelter under less permanent structures. This small juvenile fish was hiding within an old banana leaf tray, but it turns out even the worst spots are in high demand.
Oh, look at this little fish coming into the shot. I've got no idea what he's doing though. He's trying to steal the show.
And no hiding places are off limits.
Blimey, this is a little bit creepy. I wonder if there's anything hiding under there. Oh, there is. There's a little fish, look. He looks very comfy.
The shallow rocky areas in the Indo-Pacific are covered in life, with almost every rock revealing something new. Although the critter hiding under Rock 52 decided he'd have a better chance of success if he crawled down my sleeve.
Whoa, flat rock crab! Oh, he's on my hand! No, please don't go up my sleeve!
These guys have evolved to be flat to help them squeeze into tight spaces.
Oh, this one looks pretty good.
Hiding under rock number 57 was his small brown starfish, and under rock number 59 was a rocky tube that it turns out was crafted by a species of tube worm. These tube worms create their tubes by secreting a mucus. However, many sea creatures use rocks and rubble for more than just hiding. And under rock number 62, we found something very special.
Right, let's have a look under this one. Whoa, this one's covered in eggs. I'm not sure whose eggs though, possibly a damselfish. But the parents don't seem to be home, so let's get these guys back to safety. There we go. Perfect.
At this point, we were close to our final destination, but the graveyard is not easy to find, especially at night.
Oh, I've got no idea where we are. I swear the graveyard is over here somewhere.
However, at night, many creatures emerge from under the sand to feast, and what we found under Pot 81 was making the most of an easy meal.
Whoa, what is that? So, this cluster of white balls here, these are actually cuttlefish eggs. But this scene's a little bit morbid though, because in and amongst them appears to be some predatory snails. And I'm pretty sure they're feasting on the cuttlefish eggs.
Like so many other marine species, this is why cuttlefish lay so many eggs. It's possible that for every 10,000 eggs these cuttlefish lay, only one will survive to adulthood. But after swimming around for hours looking for the graveyard, eventually we found it.
Oh, I found it, the graveyard. Oh, and there's predators everywhere.
And if you're looking for a good reason why it's not a good idea to flip rocks on the ocean floor, keep watching, because this reef provides many.
Whoa, we've got to be careful here. Look, this is why I've got to be careful where I put my hands. Because this is a tasseled scorpionfish, and this guy has some venomous spines. You can see them just poking up.
But these scorpionfish are the least of your worries, for highly venomous black long-spined and double-spined urchins cover the reef here.
Urchin. They're literally everywhere. This reef is deadly.
And they are a lot faster than you think.
So people don't think that urchins can move fast. Well, look at this guy go. He's racing over the reef. He's kind of stopped now, but he was going a lot quicker a minute ago, I promise.
In addition, almost every crevice is occupied by white-eyed, yellow-edged, and snowflake moray eels that are armed with a set of jaws that can take off your finger. And as if that wasn't already bad enough, some fish will stalk you.
This is another reason why you've got to be careful, is because of these guys. No, don't do it, and they'll sneak up on you. And these spines are very venomous. There's been many times when I've been diving at night and you turn around and one of these guys is stalking you, and it's because they use the torchlight to hunt. What's this one gonna do?
Joe!
Oh! But little did I know that something much more dangerous was hunting close by. And to make things worse, they are nearly invisible. Under rock number 93 was this banded coral shrimp, a species of cleaner shrimp that earns safe passage on the reef in exchange for providing a cleaning service. Rock number 94 was the hiding place of this large brittle star. And under rock number 95 was another bizarre looking echinoderm. This is a sea cucumber. But on the reef at night, the quality of your camouflage can be the difference between life and death. And as such, many critters have developed intricate costumes in order to stay hidden. It turns out that rock number 96 wasn't a rock at all. This is a large decorator crab, a member of a group of marine crabs that fix rubble and debris to their carapaces in order to avoid catching the attention of large crustacean-eating species like triggerfish and puffers. However, this giant box crab seems to have taken his inspiration from a French bakery. Now, the shallow reefs that surround Indo-Pacific islands are laced with dangerous critters, but there is one that's in a league of its own. Not only is this species the deadliest fish in the ocean, but it also boasts some of the most impressive camouflage in the animal kingdom.
Oh, that's definitely a rock I don't want to flit. Oh dear. So this here is an estuarine stonefish, and this is the deadliest fish in the world. And this is why I was worried about coming to the graveyard, because if I accidentally flipped him over, one of these 13 very venomous dorsal spines would go into my hand. And to make matters worse, there's a second one just here. That is lethal.
But there were a lot more than two.
Oh my word, what is going on? It's an annual meeting of the estuarine stonefish.
And on that note, guys, I'm getting out of here.
If you're new here, make sure to hit that subscribe button. And if you want to see what other crazy marine life patrols these reefs at night, you'll definitely enjoy this video.